Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to run SonarQube server in a Docker container with external database. In our earlier video, we have seen how to run SonarQube in a Docker container and bootstrapping the quality configurations. Refer this video to get more details on how to set up the SonarQube in a Docker container and bootstrap the quality configurations. The default H2 database was used to run the SonarQube server. But this will be only suited for development purpose. For production, the SonarQube server should be running with the external databases. Let us now see how to run a SonarQube server in a Docker container with Postgres database. We are going to use the custom SonarQube image built in the earlier video and the standard Postgres database image. The Docker Compose will be used to run the multi-container application. The multi-container application is composed through docker-compose.yaml file. The extension can be YML or YAML. Let us now see the details on docker-compose.yaml file. So let me open that. I already committed the file to the same repository, SonarQube with custom plugins AEM. So you can refer that. The first one is the version 3.8. This is the docker-compose file version. 3.8 is the latest one. Then here we are defining the services. The first one is SonarQube, then the image. This is the custom image we built as part of the earlier video. So, and it hosted here on Tech Forum SonarQube with custom plugins AEM. This helps us to bootstrap the SonarQube server with the required quality configurations. Then we are specifying a name, container name, SonarQube. The next one is depends on. This container is depend on this DB container. Then ports, we are mapping 9000. Then networks, SonarNet, we are naming it. You can name it whatever you want. Then some environment variable, JDBC username, password, then URL. This is the default DB port. This is the custom environment variable the image is using. The SonarQube admin password, welcome one. Then volumes, we are mapping two volumes. SonarQube data, SonarQube logs. To OPT SonarQube data and OPT SonarQube logs. In the earlier one, we mapped to a host folder, but here we are mapping to the internal Docker volume. So then next one is DB. Here again, we are using the standard image, Postgres, latest, specifying a name for that, container name, Postgres, same networks, then environment variable, Postgres user, password, and DB name. Then one volume we are mapping here, Postgres SQL data to var lib Postgres SQL data. Then the network driver bridge. Then here we are defining all these volumes. We are having three volumes, SonarQube data, SonarQube logs, Postgres SQL data. Let us now run the application. I am into this folder. If you see, there is a file called docker-compose.yml on the same project, SonarQube with custom plugins AEM. Let me run the docker compose command, docker, then compose, then up. Even you can add minus D, it means the containers will be running in background. I am not running that. The server startup failed with this exception, max virtual memory areas, vm.max map count 2621 is too low, increase to at least 262144. So to fix this, we should be executing this command vm.max map count 2621 44 to increase the maximum number of memory map areas for VM. Otherwise, the SonarQube server exit with exception while starting with Postgres SQL. Let me stop the containers. Okay. Execute Docker Compose again. Docker Compose up. Now the SonarQube server is up with the Postgres DB and the quality configurations are bootstrapped. Let me open the Docker desktop first. If I go here, yeah, you can see the container here. Then if you maximize, there are two containers. One is Postgres latest, another one is SonarQube. Then it is with Tech Forum SonarQube with custom plugins AEM latest. Let me access the SonarQube server now. 9000 just in the password is already changed to welcome one. required quality gates are defined. If I go to quality gates, I can see AEM, it's a default. And if you go to quality profiles, you can see the custom profile also. AEM way Java, Sonar way, it's narrating from. Now the SonarQube server is ready. You can scan your application. Let us quickly see some of the additional commands. The first one is Docker compose logs. So you will be able to see the container logs here. So the minus F parameter specify the current logs. So if I execute this, remove this. Yeah, you can see the logs. So if you want the current logs, then you can just execute minus F. Yeah, the running logs, you can see it. That's fine. So another one is like you can Docker volume list. You can list out all the volumes. Yeah, as we discussed, we are creating three volumes. One is for Postgres SQL data, SonarQube data, and SonarQube logs. So then if you want to remove any of the volume, so you can just specify this. Minus F means we are forcing it. You can specify the label. You can remove the specific volume. The next one is if you want to inspect, you can inspect the volume. If I go here, copy this, then specify the specific volume. It will show you all the details, the mount point, then what is the name, then scope, all the labels also, then driver local. So same way, if you want to only get the mounts, you can execute on a container, like on the SonarQube container, I want to get all the mounts. So execute this, so it will display, there are like two mount points we are using it. Yeah. Then if you want to corrupt the mount point only, you can execute this specific command. So if I execute, then I need to replace this volume label here. Yeah, maybe let me take this volume. Yeah. It will show you the mount point. Even you can start and stop the existing containers. Execute this Docker compose then stop. Yeah, the existing containers are getting stopped. Now you can start it. Docker compose start. Yeah. Yeah, another one is like if you want to execute some command inside the container, you can execute this. Let me copy this. Here now I will give the container ID as SonarQube. Now the bash is opened. Now if you do ls, yeah, you are into the container. Even you can see the path. Yeah, opt SonarQube. Then if you want to see the logs, cd logs, ls, yeah, you can see the all the logs. Bi might not, you can do a cat. Yeah, you can see the log. That's all for today. Refer this URL for the commands referred here. The Git repository is updated with the YAML file. If you see here, yeah, it's already updated with the YAML file. You can download and build it. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.